see the grid, which is so important because aesthetic. And ayun, you can cross post Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest. Tapos ayun, it's with that account. Now, if I had other people to help me, then that would probably be different. But I guess in my situation, because I'm alone, it helps na just once a month I do the content and then I just let it go so I can focus on other stuff. So yun. What do you use, madam?
Yeah, right. Ako din before, up until now, use Planoly for post scheduling for Instagram, and then I also use Facebook Creator Studio. So if you have a page, you can go to your Creator Studio, you can go ahead and schedule it for your Facebook feed, etc., etc. And I like it. Na yun nga, very automated na siya. And hindi naman na kailangan isipin. Parang you just have to dedicate one day of your week to post at least 1 to 2 weeks worth of content. And that's it. Ano pa ba? Google Drive. For all of the photos, especially now that most of us are working from home, para rin at least lahat ng photos, lahat ng graphics are HD and stuff. So, yeah.
Ano pa bang, meron pa ba kayo bang ginagamit? Yeah, I think mostly it. Medyo very helpful naman yung mga built-in analytics ng Facebook and Instagram. So, if you wanna grow your social media platform, or your social media pages, it really helps to understand the numbers. Madami namang tutorials sa YouTube University, ganyan. So, if you're ever confused, it's such a good way to learn.
True.
Alright, next question is from Neko Mi. Can or how do introverts survive and grow business? In relation to that, how to deal with being shy in promoting and or marketing your business? How do you build connections with and gain customers with relatively zero connections in the field or niche? Thank you. Yeah, do you consider yourself an introvert or extrovert?
I am. Siguro ambivert nga. So, and it was a struggle for me in the beginning. I mean, I could genuinely talk to people in events and enjoy it, but I have to hibernate for at least 1 to 2 days before I can have the energy to talk to people again. Ako, in terms of promoting and marketing your business, I think you just have to do it. You don't need to be, if you are a super duper introvert, you don't need to be on video or Facebook lives. Alam mo yan, kahit posts lang on social media, because you really need to be seen online nowadays. Mm-hmm. You have to be visible. Kasi, people won't talk about your business if you yourself won't talk about it. I mean, paano nilang malalaman kung may business ka? Tsaka, hey, you have to be proud of your hard work in the first place. Na parang, share them your story, ganyan-ganyan. Well, in terms of building connections naman, I started with joining Facebook groups. I interact with them, ask questions, just give out relevant answers or comments sa mga posts, and that way people will start seeing you more and trust you more. Tapos that's also where you can also practice talking to people and not be shy about it. Kasi you know, nasa Facebook ka lang naman, and ayun. Tapos ano pa ba? Next is networking events, which we don't have anymore, and I genuinely miss. Alam mo yun.
But
sometimes, yun nga, with networking events, sometimes I wanna go by myself just so I'm forced to talk and network to other people. Kasi usually kapag kasama ko si Josh, parang laging siya yung lifesaver ko sa conversation. Kasi di nga ako masyadong mahilig dumaldal. Kasi he's such a very people person. So, siya lagi yung nagdadala ng conversation and stuff. So, parang andan na naman ako sa cocoon ko. Tahimik lang ako. Parang lagi lang magnanod. Okay. So, usually, kapag nga, uncomfortable ka or mag-isa ka lang, napaforce talaga ako makipag-usap sa iba. So, yun nga. As an introvert, it will surely be uncomfortable. But, yun nga. If you continuously want to grow, this applies to life and business, by the way. Prepare to always be uncomfortable and awkward. And you have to start embracing that. So, ayun.
When I think about the first idea is you can grow it without necessarily using your face. It's not like if you were in a bazaar. Because in a bazaar, you need to reach out to people like, "Hi, ma'am, sir, ito po, try niyo po." You don't have to do that on social media. On social media, you can be your brand and you can promote your brand without ever showing yourself out there. Although it will definitely help because it helps if a brand has a personality. Pero you can build a personality through the brand itself. There are so many ways to go about it. You can have your Facebook ads. You can reach out to influencers through the brand account. You can, you know, send people PR packages. You know, when I started Morena, tuwang-tuwa ako kasi people started sharing just the Morena photos, not even through me, as in through just the Morena, the label account. And then Dominique Cuanco and Kiana Valenciano both saw it and they liked the post and then they commented on the post. And I was like, oh my gosh, hala, like, kilala, alam mo yan, like, personally, hindi ko naman sila kilala, like, I'm not in their circle, whatever. But then I messaged them using the Morena, the label account. And so, after nun, like, I've been sending kids. So they can also, so for Asana, they can also edit and add more for their to-do lists in a day. Just so after a week, I can see the progress then. Kung ano ba yung nag-productive pa sila this week, ano ba yung natapos nila, ganyan. And it also lessens the meetings. Kasi may mga, ano nang status nito? Oh, let's go around the room. Anong status nito? Parang hindi ko na kailangang mag-ganon na.
Yeah.
Just because I have Asana and a great project management tool. Tapos, ano pa ba? Yeah, Google products ako din. Tsaka, syempre, Zoom. Especially now that we are almost parang, ilan ba?
4 months?
Mga 60% naman. 60% of my staff works from home. So, ayan, Zoom is life. Javan. Shout out to my account managers, Mela and Mark. They have the best customer service, I must admit. And they also offered a program called COD Advance. Hindi ko alam kung na-chika ko na sa'yo ito, madam. So, kasi diba tayong mga Pinoy, mahilig talaga tayo sa cash on delivery. But for us business owners, we can only receive your cash on delivery payment after a week. So, for example, if a client pays today, we will receive it in our bank accounts the following week pa. Ganun pag cash on delivery kasi. As a business, di ba, sobrang crucial ng cash flow. Yung maikot ng pera, kumbaga. So, when they rolled out COD Advance, ang mangyayari is when lahat ng mga na-encode mo sa system na cash on delivery, i-deposit na agad nila yung 50% nun sa bank account mo the next day.
Whoa.
Whether if it's delivered or not. Ayan. Kasi diba usually, parang magde-deposit lang sila sa'yo ng COD remittances kapag received na ni client.
Yeah, so matagal.
But with COD Advance, parang I actually calculated it takes around 2 weeks before you get from shipping your parcel to getting the money. Parang roughly 1.5 to 2 weeks, ganyan. So sayang yun, diba, yung cost of money. But yeah, ang saya nun kasi kahit na-deliver na siya or hindi, babayaran ka ng at least 50%. So if you guys are interested, you can connect with me on Instagram if we have business owners right here. So I can make it easy with them. Hashtag not sponsored, but I won't complain if they sponsor us in the future.
They sponsor us in the future. I love it. I also just onboarded with Ninja Van yesterday. Tapos, ayun, I'm so excited because number one, my issue with LBC is great, especially kung patingi-tingi. But right now, during the quarantine, oh my gosh, have I told you about my experience with LBC the last couple of weeks? Kaya ako pagod na pagod because I wake up before 7 so that I can be at the LBC store by 7:15. And then pagdating ko sa 7:15, 8 o'clock yung bukas ah, 7:15 nandun na ako, kukuha ko number, and I'm like 20 plus.
Oh my God.
Uuwi ako. provincial orders. So with my ano naman, Metro Manila orders, natutunan ko to from Riza. So ayun, I have my in-house delivery network
na. Oh my gosh!
Love it! Yeah, so I work directly. Since medyo regular naman yung deliveries namin, we partnered with mga riders. We have like 3 riders that we work with para sa kanila na diretso yung ano, yung shipping fee. Which is so nice kasi parang, you know, we have more people that we work with.
Exactly. And we help them as well.
So, yeah. If ano, I guess for the best career question, Digivan, especially if ano, nationwide and COD, if Metro Manila and meron ka namang regular na ano, regular na kuya na pwede mong kausapin, it helps to build a relationship, like a personal relationship with them. Para, alam mo yan, like, trusted mo na rin for COD, for immediate deliveries. Ayun, it really helps. Pati customer satisfaction. Mas mabilis dumating sa kanila. Tutuwa rin sila. Exactly. And then ako, LBC. Pagka hindi na talaga. Yeah.
When all else fails.
When all else fails, we have LBC. Pipila na lang talaga matagal.
Yes. 4 hours of work.
Never again. Okay, from Aldrich Cancino. How do we use social media in advertising the product or service? And how much should I risk?
Well, kasi, ano ba, social media is free. So utilize it to the best of your abilities. Kami, we post at least 4 times a week. And, I know, it's also best to acknowledge your client tags, messages. Reply to them, please.
Yeah.
Reply to every single one of them. It's part of customer service. And it, they will really appreciate it kapag nagre-reply talaga. Lalo kapag personalized yung reply. Mm. Kasi, yeah, oo, part yan ng customer service. And you know what? Even if sa amin, on our end, if there's a bad comment, sometimes you get tempted to block na lang kaya natin to or ban na lang. But if it's a reasonable complaint, you have to go out of your way to deal with it head on. Ako, usually, if I get DMs or messages from clients, I really make sure I reply to them. Especially if it's a complaint. And I really, really appreciate clients. I genuinely appreciate clients na nagsasabi sa akin or tag me in their comments, etc., etc. Kasi it's also my responsibility to make them happy. Mm-hmm. To give them value for their money. To give them value for their money. And yeah, ako kasi very, very much of a customer service person talaga ako. Tsaka, yun nga eh. Ano mo to, business mo to, and you have to take responsibility with everything.
Yeah.
Risk-wise, I don't see much of a risk, except that you have to be cautious about what you're posting. Kasi minsan pag nagkamali ka lang ng sinabi, alam mo naman, sobrang viral ka na in a bad way, and how can you even save yourself from it?
Yeah. I like that you, I like that you mentioned na social media is free. Kasi, yun nga, a lot of people think na, oh, I need to be investing so much in marketing. But if you're creative and you invest time, you can really make social media one of your primary sources of, I guess, new leads. Sobrang important na social media and advertising. Now, as for ads, it's very manageable, especially here in the Philippines. Parang you can promote a post, you can boost a post for as little as 60 pesos a day. So
exactly.
That's really doable. Even when I started, as in I would boost for a weekend. Let's say I have a weekend sale, I'd spend 400 pesos on ads and then boing, boing, boing yun. So I think if you have physical products na you, as in talagang physical inventory na madali lang ibenta, ads, Facebook ads, Instagram ads are so, so helpful. Nakita ko pa nga yung Lana sa Tinder eh.
I love
it. Lana, hinahabulo ko ng Lana.
Sorry, kami talaga, Facebook ads is life. A huge chunk of our marketing budget goes there. So, mga 80% ganyan.
Wow.
Goes to Facebook ads. Kasi nga, we utilize social media talaga. We post tags, hashtags, ganyan. So,
yeah,
make social media work for you, not the other way around.
deliver. Tapos, yun, in-optimize ko muna. When we first launched, like, 2 weeks ago, we wanted to see muna how far we can push the free advertising. Kasi, syempre, it's a small business. You don't wanna keep spending and spending on your, ano agad, your marketing agad. So, because social media is free, like, how do we get creative and how do we become resourceful and really push it para makuha natin yung reach na gusto natin without necessarily spending a lot. So, viral content, making videos, personalizing the experience, it's all doable and it's all YouTube Academy.
True. Tsaka ano, create valuable content for your community, for your clients. You can't just always do benta.
Yeah.
Para, give them a reason why they should stay with you, why they should choose you as a brand.
Alam mo ba, when I started, so recently I started posting educational content on Morena. Tapos grabe yung reach niya. As in, nagugulat ako. As in, yung shares and bookmarks. As in, we would reach like 300, 400 shares. Just parang, what? And that's not paying anything. That's just me. The stuff that I would share on my personal account, like, because I used to post a lot about, you know, like, colorism, ganyan. And instead of posting it on my personal account, I would post sa Morena and then make infographics. Tapos grabe talaga. Like, people just like na they're getting something out of it na hindi nila kailangan bayaran. Because at the end of the day, you know, it's not just a product, it's an experience. And you want to be there for them whether they're buying or not. Because, yeah, it's not just about the money, it's about your presence and why they're part of the community.
Amen. So our next question is from Grazie or Grazie. How to properly price physical goods?
But then, at the end of the day, how much are you paying your labor? How much are you paying yung overhead costs? So, a good estimate, I guess, would be to start with the cost of the raw materials, ganyan. And then after that, magdigdig ka na for labor cost and overhead. Somebody gave me advice before na like 20% daw of your product cost, you add on top of that, and then another 20% for labor. So you have a breathable space na you can, you know, move your products around without naghihingalo ka na sa business. So it's important to have profit. Kasi I keep seeing these online shops pinapush down yung profit to the point na ang hirap maging sustainable ng business.
Tsaka at the end of the day, it's a business and you have to take profit out of it.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, I mean, you pay people and you can't pay people without making profit.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's part of it.
So yeah, on my end, you can go ahead and pause this podcast, get a pen and paper, and compute with me. 3, 2... Okay, welcome back. Compute. Ito yung ganito ako mag-compute on how I price my physical product. So, yun nga, yung cost of goods, how yung raw materials, kung magkano mo nakukuha talaga yung product. And then, ito yung mga i-add mo, yung cost of goods, salaries, utilities, which is rent, water, electricity, internet. And you also have to take into account your marketing budget. How much is your budget for influencers, for example, or Facebook ads? Then get the total and then divide it to your inventory. So let's say, for example, eto na lang. For example, you're selling phone cases. And then let's say you can move 100 phone cases in a month. Tapos, ang cost ng phone case is 200 pesos yung paggawa, for example. So that's 200 times 100. 200 pesos times 100. That will bring you up to 20,000. And let's say, for example, your salary, you're paying one person, that's 15,000. Let's say, for example, and then your rent is 4,000. Water is 1,000. Talagang naglagay ako ng computation.
Go, go, go. Yeah. Gusto ko, I'm listening.
your total cost would be 45,000 pesos divided by 100. That's the number of phone cases you can sell in a month. That would be 400.